This program will provide instructions on how to perform qualitative fit testing for half-face filtering facepiece respirators, such as 3M healthcare particulate respirators and surgical masks. Please note the qualitative fit testing instructions for the 3M 1870 respirator and surgical masks are the same for other 3M particulate respirators. There are two types of fit test solutions for qualitative fit testing available from 3M. A sweet solution as found in the 3M FT10 fit test kit, and a bitter solution as found in the 3M FT30 fit test kit. Either of these solutions can be used. However, certain employees may be more sensitive to one solution over the other. During this training, we will be using the sweet solution. The procedure is the same for the bitter solution. Both the 3M FT10 Sweet and FT30 Bitter qualitative fit test apparatus meet the performance criteria for fit testing respirators under the current OSHA standard for respiratory protection, 29 CFR 1910.134. If crystals are present within the container of test solution, hold closed bottle under a warm stream of water or shake vigorously to dissolve the material. If there is evidence of solution contamination, immediately discard the bottle. OSHA requires that a medical evaluation be conducted prior to fit testing. A fit test should only be conducted if there is no hair growth, apparel, jewelry, or any other condition or object that may compromise the fit or prevent contact of the respirator with the skin. Subjects should be informed of the ingredients of the fit test solution and that they will be exposed to a fine mist. To prepare the qualitative fit test apparatus, attach the hood to the collar by placing the drawstring between the flanges on the collar. Tighten the drawstrings and tie it with a square knot or bow. Pour approximately 1 teaspoonful or 5 milliliters of the sensitivity solution into the nebulizer labeled Sensitivity Test Solution. Pour the same amount of fit test solution into the second nebulizer labeled Fit Test Solution. Immediately recap the bottles. A sensitivity test is conducted before the fit test to determine if the healthcare worker being tested can detect the test aerosol at very low levels. The sensitivity test solution is a very dilute version of the fit test solution. The subject must avoid eating, smoking, drinking, or chewing gum for at least 15 minutes before the test and during the test at all times. This does not include water. To conduct the sensitivity test, instruct the test subject to place the hood and collar assembly over their head without a respirator. Position the hood assembly forward so there is about 6 inches or 15 centimeters between the subject's face and the hood window. Instruct the test subject to breathe normally through their mouth with their tongue slightly extended. Both plugs on the nebulizer must be removed during use. The nebulizer must be held in an upright position to ensure aerosol generation. Using the first nebulizer with the sensitivity solution, inject the aerosol into the hood through the aperture in the hood window. Squeeze 10 times, always fully collapsing the nebulizer bulb on each squeeze. Allow the bulb to extend fully between squeezes. Ask the test subject if they can taste the sweet taste of the solution. If the test subject can taste the solution during the 10 squeezes, note the number of squeezes as 10 and proceed to the fit test. If the test subject cannot taste the solution during the 10 squeezes, inject an additional 10 squeezes of the aerosol into the hood and see if the test subject can taste the solution at this time. Repeat with 10 additional squeezes up to a total of 30 if necessary. Note whether the test subject can taste the solution after 20 or 30 squeezes. If the test subject is unable to taste the solution after 30 squeezes, end the test. Another fit test method must be used for this test subject, such as use of the FT32 bitter solution or a quantitative fit test method. Remove the test hood from the subject. give the subject a few minutes to clear the taste from their mouth. The test subject may help clear the taste of the test solution by rinsing their mouth with water. You are now ready to conduct the fit test. According to OSHA, the respirator to be tested shall be worn for at least 5 minutes before the start of the fit test. This allows time for the wearer to ensure they can wear the respirator comfortably. Have the subject don and perform the user seal check as instructed in the fitting procedures for the specific respirator. We are using the 3M 1870 Healthcare Particulate Respirator Type N95 for demonstration purposes. Instruct the subject to place and position the test hood as before. Then have them breathe normally through their mouth with their tongue slightly extended. Instruct the subject to raise a hand or otherwise notify the instructor if the sweet taste of the test solution is detected at any time. Using the second nebulizer labeled Fit Test Solution, inject the Fit Test aerosol using the same number of squeezes used in the sensitivity test, 10, 20, or 30. To maintain an adequate concentration of aerosol during this test, inject 1/2 the number of squeezes used in the previous test every 30 seconds thereafter. For instance, if the subject could taste the sensitivity solution within 10 squeezes, you would then administer 10 squeezes of the fit test solution initially and then follow up with an additional 5 squeezes every 30 seconds for the remainder of the fit test. Conversely, if it took 30 squeezes of the nebulizer for the test subject to taste the sweet solution during the sensitivity test, then you would administer 30 squeezes of the fit test solution to start the fit test and then follow up with an additional 15 squeezes of the nebulizer every 30 seconds for the remainder of the fit test. After the initial aerosol is injected, ask the subject to conduct a series of exercises for 60 seconds each. Remember to inject 1/2 the number of original squeezes every 30 seconds through the fit test exercises. First, in a normal standing position without talking, the subject shall breathe through their mouth normally for 60 seconds. Second, in a normal standing position, the subject shall breathe slowly and deeply through their mouth, taking caution so as not to hyperventilate. Continue this for 60 seconds. Third, standing in place and breathing through their mouth, the subject shall slowly turn their head from side to side between the extreme positions on each side, pausing momentarily to inhale at each side. Repeat for 60 seconds. Fourth, standing in place and breathing through their mouth, the subject shall slowly nod their head up and down with about one nod per second for 60 seconds. Instruct the subject to inhale in the up position when they are looking toward the ceiling. Fifth, the subject shall talk out loud slowly and loud enough so as to be heard clearly by the test conductor for 60 seconds. A reading called the Rainbow Passage is included in the print instructions for the 3M Qualitative Fit Test. Sixth, have the subject bend over at the waist as if he or she were to touch their toes for 60 seconds. Jogging in place may be substituted for this exercise. Conclude by asking the subject to breathe through their mouth normally again for 60 seconds. If the fit test is completed without the subject detecting the sweet taste of the test solution, an adequate face seal has been demonstrated with the model of respirator. If the subject detects a sweet taste at any time during the fit test, an inadequate fit is indicated. Terminate the testing when this happens. Wait at least 15 minutes if you plan to retest. Rinsing the mouth with water can help remove any lingering sweet taste. Ask the subject to review the donning instructions. Repeat the fit test after re-donning and readjusting the respirator. A second failure may indicate that a different size or model respirator is needed for that employee, such as another model of a 3M Healthcare Particulate Respirator and surgical mask. The fit test must be completed successfully before a healthcare worker can be allowed to wear a specific model respirator. One commonly used strategy is to fit test all employees on a single respirator model. Those who cannot achieve an adequate fit are then provided another model. For example, you may choose to fit test all employees on a 3M 1870 respirator. Those who cannot achieve an adequate fit after several tries are then provided a 3M 1860 respirator or a 3M 1860S respirator for employees with smaller faces. The fit test procedure is then repeated. Although not illustrated during this training, according to the U.S. OSHA Respiratory Protection Standard, fit testing must be performed while the test subject is wearing any applicable safety equipment that may be worn during actual respirator use, which could interfere with respirator fit, such as hair bonnets and eyewear. After completing the qualitative fit test, the unused solutions in the nebulizers should be discarded. Immediately rinse the nebulizers with warm water to prevent clogging. After allowing the nebulizers to dry, store them in a clean and dry place. There are many other types of respirators available on the market, including powered air purifying respirators or PAPRs. PAPRs equipped with a loose-fitting facepiece or hood may be an alternative for a bearded healthcare worker or those who otherwise are unable to pass a fit test on another type of respirator because PAPRs do not need to be fit tested. PAPRs use a motor and a blower to force air through air purifying elements into a loose-fitting face piece or hood that generally covers the entire face and head. A battery and cartridge are often housed in a separate unit which is mounted at the waist of the user. PAPRs must be used in connection with the same OSHA respiratory protection standard that covers use of all respiratory protection equipment in the workplace, OSHA 29 CFR 1910.134. As required by OSHA, respiratory protection programs must include procedures for cleaning, disinfecting, inspecting, storing, and maintaining equipment. However, as noted previously, PAPRs with loose-fitting face pieces, hoods, or helmets do not need to be fit tested. Refer to the OSHA website at www.osha.gov for the most current information about use of respirators. Contact your 3M sales representative or call the 3M Healthcare Customer Helpline for information on personal protective equipment, including the respirators described in this training, and to learn more about the other elements of a respiratory protection program.